laughing tonight. We're going to have so much fun just for us. This is special time for us, everybody. And I hope you appreciate just how special it's going to be. So we're going to kick right in by introducing our two teams. And I want the most thunderous applause you can muster. The acoustics are really great in this place, so it's going to sound like thousands. So we're going to introduce our team captain for team number one. So please welcome to the stage Mr. Cecil Baldwin.
Hi, everybody.
And then Cecil, would you like to introduce in your finest Welcome to Night Vale voice your teammates?
Let's see. Come on out here. Symphony Sanders, also from Welcome to Night Vale.
We're number one.
And then come on here from MST3K, Bill, come on out.
Bill Corbett.
Bill Corbett.
Mr. Bill, come on out.
Mr. Bill, come on out.
Frank.
Mr. Bill. Oh, no.
Coming up.
And then, listen, while team number two is coming out, team number one, think about what your team name is going to be.
We are.
Okay. Got it. So team number two, our captain, Lisa Correo.
Roller Disco Queen.
Lisa Roller Derby Correo entering the stage. All skate.
What is happening? Okay. Hi, everybody. Hey, guys.
Lisa, would you like to introduce your teammates?
My teammates, you guys, from Mystery Science Theater. First of all, Frank Conniff. And then, of course, Trace Beaulieu. Out here, you guys.
We now officially outnumber you people.
The very definition of a smattering of applause.
Trace, you can feel free to move my balls. Sorry for making it awkward backstage.
These
balls. Ping pong balls.
Oh,
just
no.
Making it absolutely clear.
Yes. Where
come
did
on,
those
it's a
come
family
from?
Show.
Got a
Kangaroo
lot of
Kangaroo Live.
Under the table.
Oh, can we do Captain Kangaroo Live next year?
Yeah.
Okay. So, team number one, what is the team name that you've chosen?
We are called The Problematics.
Oh, I have one, I'll say.
The Problematics.
That's right. And we hope to live up to that name by the end of the evening.
Team number two, your team name?
Our team name is Shithole Country.
Nice.
Also one for the kids.
I know you don't like
that.
Oh,
I'm sorry. I didn't know there was a kid in the
earmuffs.
Audience.
Earmuffs. It'll be fine. Earmuffs.
So instead, it's a shit house.
Get that kid a drink.
So we have The Problematics versus Shit House Country, which sounds like a genre of music that I'm sure has a serious channel.
I think that's Shit Kicker Country.
All country is shithole.
You know what?
Eight-year Africa.
I think what we're going to do is we're going to start out with a pop culture guessing game. Already getting feedback on not wanting to do the game.
No feedback from the audience, just the guess.
So the way this
burn.
Works
we
is...
We want to hear some noise coming from somewhere.
Burn.
I have indigestion.
Just fart or something, please.
We're gonna do with we're gonna go with team one first. We're gonna go with The Problematics to start, and the way this game works is you're gonna try and get your teammates, whoever you're gonna nominate to be the person prompting, get your teammates to guess what pop culture character, movie, or TV series you're trying to describe without using any proper nouns from whatever that character is to describe.
Does wait, that, what's yeah. a proper noun?
Do you remember we played
person,
this in...
Person, place, or thing.
Oh, got it.
Remember we played this in Dragon Con?
I
misconstrued your instructions to use no noun.
No nouns at all.
No nouns at all.
Yes.
So I was using, like, adverbs and prepositions and stuff. I won't do that this time.
Okay, so...
Wait, I have a question.
Yes.
So it's no nouns or no proper nouns?
No proper nouns.
So that's like a specific...
Specific, yeah. So anything that would be capitalized...
Right, so like in...
Like his sidekick was Robin.
Like if you were saying, let's say it was Harry Potter,
Harry Potter. Don't say Harry Potter.
Don't say Harry Potter. Don't use character names.
Wizard.
Right. You can say he goes to a wizarding school. You can't say he goes to Hogwarts.
No
problem. Oh, okay.
So who's going to be the one prompting, delivering?
Ooh. You're the captain. I think you should.
Okay, I'll start it off.
Okay. So, Cecil, if you want to come over by me, and what? I think use this mic in front of me, you can use.
He's already imprinted on this mic, though.
I know. This is my imprint mic.
Now, you can pass. Now, we used to have our scorekeeper. So for everyone I say correct to, click on, and that is a point to their team.
Great.
And you can pass if you don't think they're getting it.
Okay,
or you
can I pass as many times as I need to?
Yes.
Okay.
Until you run out of
we
cards.
We believe in you, scorekeeper.
So here you go.
He previous.
And you have 60 seconds to do this. On your mark. Hold on. Touch ID. So close. Excitement's palpable. Where's the clock? Almost there.
That's entertainment.
Go!
Okay, so this is a sci-fi movie that takes place in the future, made in the 70s, I think, in which they like...
Logan's Run?
Yes, Logan's Run. He eats honey and has a little...
Winnie the Pooh.
Yep. She uses an umbrella to fly.
Mary Poppins.
Yep. He's the least favorite Star Wars character of all times.
Oh, Jar Jar Binks.
Yep. He travels around in a giant call box.
Oh, Doctor Who.
Yep. They are a comedy, British comedy. They make lots of movies back in the...
Monty Python.
Yep. He's big and green and...
Jolly Green Giant. The Hulk.
Yep.
Same guy.
He's a giant tree and he travels around with his buddies in the universe and they made movies up
from... Oh, Groot!
Yep.
Groot! I am Groot.
This is the name of a movie. It's a Marvel movie that just came out.
Iron Man, Black Panther,
Thor, Ragnarok.
Yeah.
You're the blonde one.
It's what Darth Vader was making.
Pop it down. Go.
Oh, damn it.
Sorry. Going. And time.
Okay.
Pottery.
He was good team.
The no proper nouns thing made it really difficult.
That's hard.
Jeez.
You know, how am I going to reuse that card for another game?
No, it's a sci-fi film.
Never again.
These cost money.
Forever unclean.
They certainly do not.
Chanel's Country, who's going to be your prompter for this game?
I'll go. Is that okay, guys?
Yes, please. Yes. Thank you.
Okay, so I'm going to move to this.
I feel confident, though.
Be careful. When you said the least popular character in Star Wars, I almost said Hayden Christensen.
The dialogue from that one.
Yeah, this does not bode well, by the way.
No. Oh, I'm sorry. This is really awkward with this game.
We're going to get into some weird
little
game.
Eyes wide shut.
So here are your cards, and we are. Are you ready to go?
It's the witch's
no. Wait. So I can just say pass to any of these?
Yes. Any ones you want to pass on, you just throw the card down, and we're golden.
Okay.
Okay, go!
Pass! Pass! Dang it, pass! Okay.
What are you yelling?
These are guys in space and nerds all over the place. Love them so much.
Star Wars.
Close.
Star Trek.
Yeah. Okay,
I got half right.
I'm passing on that one. Okay, so she's really strong, and she has a sword. And
Wonder Woman.
No, she's got a big sword and big muscles. Huge, big muscles.
Hillary Clinton.
close enough, pass. It was Xena. Okay, pass. I suck at this. We're going to lose. We're losers. Okay, I'm passing on that one. Okay, this is a little bird with webbed feet. But he has aim.
Donald Duck.
He's like from space. And
oh, Marvin the Martian. Dodgers.
He's a Marvel guy, and he's in the end of the.
Oh, the one of the things in the Guardians
Howard,
of the
Howard
Galaxy.
Howard the Duck.
Time.
Well, we got like
something. That's the thing that was in the movie.
Yes.
Okay, Howard the Duck movie was like literally my favorite thing from like the late 80s,
nothing
early
wrong
90s.
With that.
So hard. Yeah.
And we had it on tape. That and He-Man, Master of the Universe.
Yeah.
Anybody, Masters of the Universe? Anybody? Yeah? You?
Yeah.
Oh.
There was every version of Star
My dad
Trek.
Taped over it, though. I was really mad.
That was incredible.
Can we... I think we should get a point for the number of cards gone through.
Yes.
Sorry, guys, I let you down.
You know what?
No, not at all.
Sure, you get a point for the amount of cards passed.
Yay!
I mean,
see what begging does?
If it makes you feel better, it's not making much of a difference, but sure.
Nothing. I think we should have called our team Pink Flamingos because we just ate shit. Thank you.
So from our scorekeepers, what is the score for the problematics right now?
Yeah.
Problematics and four. For S House Country, what is the current score?
With the bonus point you just gave us?
Yes, 3.
Yes.
No. So 3.
With the bonus point, it's 3. It's
a
solid. Man.
You know what? I think we're going to bring the wheel out. Oh. I spent a lot of money on this, and it broke.
Did you really?
What?
I spent.
Well,
I spent
who's
a
the
lot.
Fool?
I don't have a lot. I was worried about cards being torn up. So let's see.
Like 400.
Listen, there's like 7 people who can come up and look at this individually
Alex
right
Trebek
now.
Alex Trebek doesn't bitch about how much he the game is costing.
He's been that light board is probably expensive. The one you just like touch the thing.
Guys,
like,
guys, I'm having trouble with the wheel, Phil.
Oh no.
Hold it. Just
this is showbiz magic, folks.
That's right. Oh,
the power of live theater.
I'm gonna hold it. Okay.
Oh, that's good.
Great.
Here's
so you're surprised that the same thing that's happened every time you've used that wheel is happening.
I mean, yeah, sort of. Is that how it works?
We'd like to thank you all for coming to the tech rehearsal.
Yes, that's great.
We'll iron this out.
Yeah. There we go.
We'll fix it in post.
Yeah. Our press opening is next weekend.
Is it spinning?
Yes.
And it's so mesmerizing.
Is it spinning?
Where did it stop?
Dance.
Dance. Oh, that's a dance party.
Oh, all right.
It's going to be really awkward. We're going to skip the dance party on this one.
Yeah. No.
Can we get a point for you skipping the dance party?
Yeah. I get a point for me skipping the dance party.
No, not them.
I want the dance party.
And an extra point for wanting the dance party.
Because okay. We actually like the dance party.
Where'd it stop?
Balls.
Balls. Okay. Oh, good.
Typical.
You put your finger on the balls.
Yeah.
Is this a game you're playing against yourself?
Do you need us to leave really, and come back?
Do you really need us here?
We don't even know the rules.
We'll see in a bit.
What is happening?
So these spoons are sealed, as you can see.
It's a
am I not supposed to unspoon?
Please remove your sealed spoon from its package.
Okay.
Oh, God.
Insert the spoon in your mouth. Not the spoon end, but the actual handle end. So you have the...
Here.
Like this.
Sterilized spoon.
Yeah.
So this is Bill and Trace who are doing this. Please each take a ball.
Let's not use names. Wait, there's still plastic on it.
Never have here and saying that's going to be on that, right?
So,
yeah.
The balls are now in the spoons.
We should get an extra point because he's injured, and you're making him do physical.
Is that his
stuff.
Ball
but
hand?
But he's not using his hand.
Yeah. It is, actually.
I'm emotionally injured. I want a point, too.
So now...
Aren't we all?
We're going to have Bill go first. Bill,
what am I doing?
Insert the handle of the spoon in, and... Say as many letters of the alphabet as you can without the ball falling from the end of the spoon. Go.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, E, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
Yeah.
That is 1 point to the problematics, Trace.
Yes.
Popeye.
Same thing?
Same thing.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
That's a 1 point.
Yeah.
What an incredibly challenging game.
Who knew these guys would be so great at talking while there's balls in their mouths?
Wow.
Oh, honey, you've seen my early work.
And now we're going to plus this by adding spoons down. So pick who's going to be second.
Do we share our ball or?
Well, here's the thing. You now have to, with no hands, transfer the ball into the person's spoon next to you.
That would be easier. Okay.
This is
easier.
Becoming very Larry Craig-esque. I didn't expect you to know that.
And go. Let's see how it goes.
We're still unwrapping.
I was. Failure.
I mean.
Do we get a second chance?
You just keep trying?
Okay, great.
But no. Second chance. One of you has to put the blindfold on that's sitting in front of you.
I thought that was a dress shield.
My ball is gone.
We lost our ball.
We lost our ball.
It's under the table.
Well, I have additional balls for you. Okay, go for it. Oh.
Wait, no,
I was monkey pawed by trade. Oh! That is a point for Shithouse Country.
You didn't say put it over my eye.
I know, you monkey pawed me. I mean, you know, so that was a point
I got it.
To Shithouse Country. That almost puts you guys on the scoreboard.
It also almost came so close to being entertainment.
Rest assured, none of this will be.
Well, you know, it's the almost entertaining quiz show panel that I love to present and also love when it's pointed out by the contestants every year we do this.
I say it with love, ladies and gentlemen. I kid because I love.
And
Arlene Francis was a bit of a bitch, too. So. I
Thank
didn't
you.
Expect you to get that.
Thank you for the What's My
By
Line.
By the Bennett Cerf of this panel.
So what we're going to do now...
Are we going back to the wheel?
No, we're moving away from to the musical segment of this evening. We're going to do a little quiz show staple in the UK called Pickup Songs. So please, on Problematics, choose your first pickup songs. Suffery, however you want to.
Right.
So while you choose, I'm going to explain to everyone. So pickup songs, what's going to happen is...
I'll do it.
I'm going to give one of the team members the lyrics to a song, a popular song. I'm going to start playback on that song. They can start singing along to it. At a certain point, I'm going to drop the volume away, and they're going to continue singing the song. I'm going to bring the volume back up after... I'm going to arbitrarily judge when it comes back up. If they're in the same place in the song, their team gets a point. So...
Good luck.
And who is doing it?
Me.
Tiffany's doing
it? I'll do it.
Oh, we can go.
It me.
And let's cue this up.
I hate this song. I've decided I would ban it for if I ever got married, that I'm going to ban this song for my wedding.
Well... Here we go.
Bonne chance.
So, Symphony, would you like to tell the audience what song it is?
This song is called The Electric Slide by Marsha Griffiths. Griffiths.
Here we go.
It's electric. It's electric, boogie. You got to feel it. It's electric. Woo, it's shaking. It's electric.
No, Mr. Cameron, I'm like a mechanic. Moving like electric. You got the boogie. Oh, nope. You got no. It's electric. Boogie, woogie, woogie. Now you can hold it. It's electric. Boogie, woogie, woogie. But you know it's there. You hear it everywhere. I've got... Nope. I don't know this song all the way. That's why I hate it. From the music. Damn it.
Say something.
Are you coming with me? Go.
Yeah, she nailed it. She nailed it.
You know, you were saying party line, yeah.
And I'll teach you the electric slide.
See? I'm going to give 1 point to the Problematics for that.
Good. I like that.
Symphony, that was incredible.
Terrible.
You know what? You made me love the song.
Thank you. Boogie, woogie, woogie.
Good night, everybody.
I had to clear
mic check,
up,
mic
I had
check.
To clear up the feedback.
Sorry, I had Mexican.
Oh, it's still there. Oh, that didn't work. Okay, so we're going to quickly launch into another song. Who's going to sing on this day? Frank?
Oh, yeah. Brave man.
All right.
You know,
only if I've heard of the song.
The thing, no. I mean, it's not going to stop for the song I'm going to choose.
Beyonce.
Okay.
Put a ring on it. Frank. Okay, let me...
Despacito.
Despacito.
You got this.
Despacito.
I think I might have heard this song, but
okay.
I'm not intimate with I'm Too Sexy.
I'm too sexy for my love.
Too sexy for my love. I was going to leave me. I'm too sexy for me. I'm too sexy. Yeah. You know, when he, I, you know, yeah, I, that, I'm too sexy for my shirt, too sexy for my shirt, so sexy it hurts. And I'm too sexy for Milan, too sexy for Milan, New York and Japan. I'm too sexy for your pate, too sexy for your pate. No way, I'm disco dancing. I'm a model, you know what I mean, and I do a little turn on the catwalk. Yeah, on the catwalk, on the catwalk. Yeah, I do my little turn on the catwalk. Too sexy for my car. Too sexy for my.
Wow. You know what? I think that may be the very first point that Frank has ever earned in this game. And if you've never heard Frank's My Way, it is incredible.
Plus, you have a new signature song now.
Yeah,
I'm too...
That's your new karaoke song.
I think so, but, you know, I think people can maybe buy the idea of me being sexy, but not too sexy. Right. That's a little far-fetched, that you went over the line of sexy. Nah, that's too much. Tamp it down a bit.
Bring it back.
Bring it back to what's a sexy that we can handle.
For me, it'll always be Frank, just sexy enough, Conniff.
Yes.
Well, you got a song that you sing all the time.
I mean, I'm sorry, it was incredible. We're moving on to another game called Home Truths. We're going to bring out a very special guest, and so what's going to happen is this guest is going to come out. Previously, they provided me with a weird truth about their past. They're going to come out. I'm going to hand them this envelope. When they open the envelope, it's either going to contain the weird truth about their life they provided or a lie I made up that they're going to have to then try and convince this esteemed panel who are going to cross-examine them that that lie is a truth or that... the truth is a truth, and you're going to have to guess at the end and determine if it's a lie or a truth. So you're going to cross-examine them. They're going to read it out. Are we ready to bring out our first home truth?
Yes.
Yes.
Yay.
Big round of applause, Mr. Michael Kingston.
Woo!
Oh, this is so exciting. Are you ready?
I suppose.
Well, that's enthusiastic.
You're lying.
Liar!
We're not playing yet.
Oh.
All right, let me get this thing working. All right, good.
Here's your envelope. Open it up and please read out its contents to the audience. I seal them really well.
I once fell through a plate glass window.
So now, both teams, you may begin throwing out cross-examination. Whatever questions you would like to ask.
Oh, that was it? That was the story?
Yeah.
Cool.
Were there any celebrities involved?
There were no celebrities involved.
What were your injuries?
I got a cut on my knee, and I was covered in glass. I had to be vacuumed.
Oh. Now, when you say you fell through the... Was the window on the floor, or was it... exactly was the window in relation to where you were?
It was a straight up and down first floor window. I was shoved through the window.
Oh, you're shoved through the window?
Yes. Wait,
by who?
Huh?
Did they go to jail?
No one went to jail. I went to the hospital and got vacuumed.
Who shoved you through a window?
A coworker.
Oh.
What precipitated this shove? Why did he do it?
Just... horsing around.
Where were you working?
At a shopping mall.
Oh, now was it as a part of a performance?
No.
So you guys were just
Wait, where in the mall did you work?
Right.
I was a janitor at the shopping mall.
Oh, okay.
What was the anchor store in this mall?
Jeez, it was a long time ago. Probably a Bon-Ton, maybe.
A which?
A Bon-Ton. It's like a high-end clothing store. It's not any place I'd ever shop.
What did your coworker do?
He pushed me, and there was a...
what was his job? He was the janitor.
He was also a janitor. There was a group of us that were janitors.
A group of custodians.
Very clean mall.
We were, yeah.
I'm going to assume his job was to push you.
he was paid very well.
What's okay.
You guys were good at cleaning except for all the glass and blood.
What were you arguing about that made him push you?
We weren't even arguing. We were just horsing around.
And so it was like fun. Oh, I'm pushing you. You're pushing me.
Sure. And then I tripped backwards over a rock that was on the ground, and I fell through the window.
So you didn't have any animosity towards him. It was an accident, right?
No, nobody has any animosity towards me.
No, but I mean
pretty,
you towards
pretty congenial
him,
fellow.
Huh?
I'm a pretty congenial fellow.
Right, so you didn't hold it against Stim that this was like an accident.
Oh, no. I mean, you know, fuck that guy.
Was this covered under workman's comp?
No, I don't miss any time. I mean, I'm kind of like an Iron Man, you know. Mm-hmm. I just came back. I got vacuumed and stitched up.
And, I mean, I'm really focusing on the vacuuming part.
Oh, wait, who
as
vacuumed
the most exciting
you?
Part of the story.
Oh, there's
who vacuumed you?
A really attractive nurse. I'm not gonna lie. I would recommend it.
You would think that your janitor friend would have a vacuum,
right? That's what I was thinking.
No, but you have to be professional. So, I mean, for those of you that can't see, I'm a pretty hairy fellow. So you got glass bits in your arm, and you know, if you don't get them out, you just touch yourself, and you'll be pushing glass into you. And I enjoy touching myself.
Yeah. I mean, it's a thing. It's a fetish,
right,
I'm sure.
So
this was not safety glass?
No, it was not safety glass.
Was it plate glass or double glazed?
I'm really not sure.
Was this during business hours or was this after hours?
It was after hours.
Oh, damn.
What was the name of this mall and what, like, town or city?
It was called Shopping Town Mall. It was in DeWitt, New York.
Shopping Town Mall?
Yeah.
Do you want a little more time to
think? The fakest sounding mall.
Were there killbots? Was this Chopping Mall? Is that what?
Was let me movie. Ask something about this mall. Was Roy Moore banned from it?
Yes.
Remember, that was topical like 3 weeks ago, remember?
Yeah. Have you been saving that joke?
Everybody knew Roy Moore around the mall. We knew to stay away from him.
And did you go back to work after this?
I did. I was vacuumed. I was stitched up in a ridiculous story about the guy that drove me to the mall. Almost had sex with his sister.
You almost, or he almost?
No, he almost did.
He almost had sex. How do you almost?
She wanted to.
Well, he was covered in glass.
No. So
it made it awkward. I guess
we went to the mall. Or not the mall, we went to the hospital, and while we were in the waiting room, he met a guy who had once been married to his sister, and then he described how they were married for about a week, and his sister was apparently of loose moral fiber, and at one point, she had tried to have sex with him.
All right.
So I went back with that story.
Here's my question. Why isn't that your story?
I wasn't really sure how that would play, you know, with the mixed audience.
And yet... It did come out.
Yeah.
Can I ask, was the guy who threw you through the window named Dalton and known as the best cooler in the business?
And does pain hurt?
I don't think he was Dalton because Dalton would have been bigger.
Yeah. Did you receive any stitches?
One stitch in my knee.
Just one?
Yeah,
one
just one. They bandaged the rest of it up.
Where was it? Where was the injury?
On my knee.
On your knee.
Yeah. And my thumb got cut, but not apparently bad enough for stitches.
It wasn't deep enough to get a stitch.
Yeah, I was lucky. I mean,
yeah, very lucky.
Because the first thing that hit the window was the back of my head.
Mm-hmm. So if you had just snitched, you would have gotten your stitches.
Oh, snap.
That was worth it. That was for me. And I don't care if anyone else cared.
Just get stitches.
Were you in a union, or was this covered under insurance through the company that your
what
janitor?
What country do you live in?
I guess it was covered. I guess it was workers' comp. Yeah.
Workers' comp. Okay. So going back to my original question, you feel like answering that one now?
Well, what was that?
Oh, wow.
Were you covered under workman's comp?
I guess I was. Yeah. I didn't think about it because I never got a bill or anything. You know, I just went and got vacuumed and. I mean, nothing came to my house.
This is like a U.S. Confirmation.
What kind of vacuum was this? Was it
a shop vac?
A shop vac. Was it a Craftsman shop vac?
In the emergency room?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, just a nurse with a shop vac. It was a normal hospital.
Ironically, it was the hospital janitor who got it.
I would also. I want to throw in.
Shop vac and like get the glass out of it.
Were they using a brush or the crevice tool?
Just the end of the hose. Like they didn't put an attachment.
The end of the hose.
Trace.
Yes.
Shop or wet? vac. Oh, ask if there was, because the hospital situation.
You know he can hear you.
You know, yeah, he's like.
I'm also mic'd. I guess that could be.
That was not an aside. That was like everyone. Yeah. Okay, wet vac or dry vac?
I'm really unsure if it had dual purpose. I didn't lose any fluids, but I'm unsure if it could have been used for fluids.
Like blood, I think.
What were you wearing? And say it slowly.
Probably shorts and a t-shirt would be my guess.
Shorts and
work
a
attire.
Yum.
I was a janitor shopping mall after hours. Like, you didn't really have to.
Workman's cash. Yeah.
Mm. And what state was this in?
New York.
New York State.
Yes.
Okay. And what year was this?
Jeez. Maybe 97?
Oh, 97. Okay.
Yeah.
It was a good year. Well,
that was.
I'm gonna
it was
add,
a great year for going through.
New York years. Wasn't a state in 97.
I'm now going to ask all both teams to confer right now to determine truth or lie on this. While we're doing so, Michael, is there anything you'd like to promote?
I read a wrestling comic book called Headlocked. I'm over in the celebrity section next to Mick Foley. You can come check out my stuff.
Oh, wow.
Boy, that conference was really short on both sides. So we're going to go with the problematics. Would you say truth or lie?
Lie.
We say truth because it was the dullest fucking story I've ever heard.
Michael, is it a truth or a lie?
It is 100% true.
I told you.
Wow.
That is 1 point to Shithouse Country. No points to the problematic.
That's you know, the phrase, you can't make this up, has new meaning here. Because you would make something up better than that.
This is a corollary. You shouldn't make this up.
Big round of applause, Michael Kingston. Thank you very much.
Woo! Yay, Michael.
I got to be honest, that went better than I thought it was going to go.
That was better?
That's a high water mark now for the evening.
He is now a Supreme Court nominee.
That's right.
He did so well.
You have a DA in your makeup there.
Like I have DA, but no getting no DNA.
You have DA in your DNA?
Yes.
We're now going to play another musical game called Doo-Doo.
Great.
So what we're going to ask is for our most musical member of each team to be the person who's going to try and get their team members to guess a song by only using the words doo-doo. No lyrics. Deliver the medley. Melody. Melody.
The medley.
Not the medley.
through doo-doos. He changed. Doo-doo.
You need the glass vacuumed out of your brain.
Wet or dry. So who's going to be the musical team member?
Yeah, I'll do it.
Doing it again.
Yeah, I'll
from
do it
the
again.
Problematics. Who is it?
It's going to be me.
Symphony's going to do
you. Hey, Symphony, please join me over here at the magic mic.
This is terrible. I don't know names of songs.
Now I want to see magic mic.
That was my magic mic.
I mean, we are in Florida, after all.
I'm right. Home of magic mic.
That's right.
We're going to give you 2 minutes, 120 seconds. For your team to guess as many, you can skip any that you don't feel are being conveyed to them.
All right.
Are you ready to go? On your mark, get set, go!
Do, 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 do,
Uh-huh. Oh,
that's it. That's the song. Yeah. That's the name of the fucking song.
Okay.
Sorry. Do 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 do.
The theme song from Silver Spoons.
Nope. I don't know that song. Oh, do 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 do.
Pour some sugar on me.
Yes. Do 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 do. Do 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 do.
Welcome to the jungle.
I don't know that song. Okay, I don't know that song. Do 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 do.
Shake your body. Shake.
Mm-mm.
Madonna. No.
Nope. Okay. Do 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 do.
Staying Alive.
Do.
Yeah.
No, I don't know that song. No.
John Cage.
No.
The theme song for the Monsters.
Oh. Do 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 do
I know that song, but I can't think of it right now. Oh my God, really? Am I blanking on that one? Cool. Nope.
The theme song from Two and a Half Men.
Nope. Really? Ken, come
on. You're done. Time.
Come on, man.
We got a couple.
Yeah.
You did.
Five.
Oh, damn. That's pretty good.
Thank you.
That was excellent.
Sorry.
You did great. You did great.
Who is going to be our musical doo-doo on Shithouse Country?
Yeah, because I was so good at
In a Shithouse Country, dreams stay with you.
That's hard, because you're like, it's just the tune.
All right.
Roll on over here.
That's not one of the songs. Hold on, I'm coming. There's no point for that.
Bumps.
Tell me when you're ready. That's encouraging.
Okay.
You can pass.
I'm
you can
ready.
Pass the first one if you'd like.
I'm going to, okay.
Okay, go.
Forget it, pass.
Take My Breath Away. Batman. Happy birthday.
Pay me. Pass.
I'm too sexy.
Yeah.
My theme song. Rickroll thing. Never gonna give you up.
Never gonna give you up.
Rickroll thing.
That is a cool answer.
Rickroll thing.
That was very well done.
They don't got it. Okay.
Greatest American Hero.
No.
Tricks are for hookers,
oh,
Michael.
Oh, God. No.
You spin me right round.
Batman theme.
Bird else in your soul. Tequila. Batman theme, 1966. Trace already got that. It's a Small World. Keep going.
Why? Wait, who are you calling them
out? This is just all your points. You're getting all these points.
What is this fuckery?
What?
This is like, can you read?
Okay. Wow, we won.
Look, if it's a...
So many songs have the same lyrics. It's hard to...
Wow, so many points. You did so well.
I'm great at this.
That final countdown was...
That was really
that
good.
That was really good.
I would have gotten that. I was
thought
already,
you did great.
I was already shooting off pennies.
I mean, I saw just the empty stares of Trace and Frank and just knew something had to be done.
Yeah, there was no other outcome possible for this game.
I just want to say Merry Christmas.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
To you both.
Thank you.
And you're welcome and happy birthday.
We don't need your charity.
Yes, we do.
And they say there's a war on Christmas.
I'm so proud of all of you right now. We're gonna get a score update. So Problematics, what score are we setting at?
17.
Problematic. And for Shithouse Country.
Nail-biting 16.
Oh!
That's all right. From our point
I'm
of
thinking
view.
It's that last round
oh, he just
that really
you like
caught you up.
Yes.
It making it
I don't mean
neck.
To be self-defeating, but it seems like we have too many points.
This is a true nail-biter, which means we're bringing the wheel back
oh,
out.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. It's the worst
Why is it
wheel
like,
ever.
Lopsided? Oh, okay.
Can you please
Whee!
Do it, Kevin? She
seems like an easier solution.
Consider for future games cutting the wheel.
Maybe we could throw darts at something.
You're going to subtract points, aren't you?
I can suggest something we could throw.
I paid a lot for this wheel. I'm going to use the wheel.
Use the wheel, Ken.
The
use
wheel the... was bigger in the picture.
Mummy.
How much?
What are we on?
No, I don't know.
I'll pay you that.
Macaroons.
Get rid of it.
It's kind of rubbed off, so could be anything.
Macaroons.
I don't know what this was. You know what? We're going to say it's balloons.
Great.
It's your...
I was like, is this a part of the show where we eat macaroons?
Yeah, that's it.
That would be great.
That would be really entertaining for you guys.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Like, this one is a violet one.
Well, guys, next time you watch a game show on TV, just appreciate what goes into the production of it.
Because
I know Ken put a lot of work into this, and it's still kind of crappy.
I can't see any of the work I put into this right now.
Apparently, you anticipated the ball thing going much longer, too.
Yeah, I know.
7 hours later.
Trace, the night is young, and I have a lot of balls. So we're going to do our balloon.
For that. I don't know. It's like,
you don't need anything. It's just a kid.
We are going to time how long it takes you to pop a balloon.
Oh.
Oh, I hate
Here's your balloon pump. Here's your balloon. I'm going to time you. Whoever gets the lowest score for inflating the balloon to popping gets a point.
You want to pop balloons?
Oh, I hate it.
Pop
balloons. Oh, my God.
You do
want to
pop balloons.
Okay.
So, who's going to inflate the balloon
on
your
team? I'm scared of balloons.
Okay. Can only one person do it? I don't want to do it.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Unless one... Someone... No.
I hate it.
This is the worst baby shower I've ever been to.
Even worse than the one where you eat the candy bar out of the diaper. That's disgusting. Never do that. Never do that. It's just word to the
wise. When we're doing our final score... Automatically, we're going to give 1 point to the problematics, a trauma point for poor Bill, who had to exit the stage.
What just happened? Did you throw up?
What did you do?
The balloons. He doesn't like balloons.
Oh.
I guess in any form. Is it also deflated balloons?
Problematic.
You better hope you don't get angina, because they...
He was molested by balloons, so...
Is your balloon securely affixed to the end of the pump?
Ready.
On your mark, get set, go. It's not as easy as it seems.
Oh, no, it's deflating.
That is...
Ah!
That was 13 seconds. Bill,
it
can
got
you,
in
can
your drink.
Can you the pump, please?
I'll still drink
scared
it.
Of pump.
Pardon me, can I get a fresh drink?
You've trained with shake weights, I take it.
So, Chanel's Country.
Sure, if that's what you want to say.
Sure, I did.
Trace.
Shake weights.
Now, we're also going to give a trauma point to Shadow's Country because Trace is injured and is going to, I assume,
oh my
he's doing
God.
This while injured.
Look, his other hand is fine.
It is a balloon blowing up accident.
Okay, Trace, are you ready? Go.
And his other hand gets taken out.
Oh, oh my God!
Shrapnel.
That is 3 seconds, and that is a point to Shadow's Country. That is 10 seconds faster.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
Wow.
It's a bionic arm now.
You are the Mike Tyson of popping balloons.
Yeah.
That was...
Yes, that's why I have 18 children.
Absolutely incredible.
And he did that in front of a female comedian. It was a tribute to Louis C.K.
Oh, wow.
Open silver, finish gold.
Boy, yeah.
So now we're going to do another round of pickup songs. So Problematics Symphony picked the last song. Who would like to do the second song for your team? So Bill, we're going to do...
You can do it, Bill.
This is going to be for Bill. Yeah, everyone cheer Bill.
Bill, 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 Bill.
Hold on a second.
I don't know the song.
What is it?
In the least.
Oh, I don't know. Hold on. We're going to swap out for 1 year. I want you to do well. I want you to do well.
Oh, it's Coconut by Harry Nilsson. I do
is
know.
Is it like the lime in the coconut?
Oh, by Harry Nilsson.
Is it lime,
I know that.
Lime in the coconut?
Yeah.
That one?
Yeah.
Oh.
All right. I think I know the chorus.
From Practical Magic?
So that should go really well.
From the movie.
Here we go.
We're winning.
That is 1 point to the professor.
You're good. Yeah, Bill.
Thank you.
That was really good.
Now I want lime and coconut.
So
can we get that cocktail?
So you just grifted. You knew the song. You knew.
It wasn't familiar at first. Once the little guitar started, I got it.
You can never go wrong with when you have Harry Nilsson's song.
This is totally how Bill scams us at every single one of these quiz. I don't know this song.
You didn't give me another song.
Totally
did you
knows. So now for that was a point for the problematics. And I'll shut out country. Who's going to be the second one on your team?
Oh, good. Yes.
You know, I want to give. I want to get the phlegmatic Trace Beaulieu.
The problematic and the phlegmatic.
Warming up your instrument.
This is going to need to be sterilized after this.
Actor Sounds, Volume 10.
Okay, this should be it.
Me. La, la, ka, 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 ka.
Oh, I don't know this at all. Oh, wait. I don't know this.
This is a great one.
In the middle of the earth, in the land of the Shire, there's a brave little hobbit whom we all admire. His long wooden pipe and his fuzzy woolly toes, he lives in a hobbit hole and everybody knows him. Bilbo.
Bilbo Baggins, he's only 3 feet tall.
Bilbo. Bilbo Baggins, the bravest little hobbit of them all. Now, hobbits are a peace-loving folk, you know. They're never in a hurry, and they take things slow. They don't like to travel away from home. They just want to eat and be left alone. But one day, oh, fuck it, Bilbo was asked to help some dwarves get back their gold that was stolen by a dragon in the days of old. That got fucked up, kind of. Bilbo.
Actually, part of the lyric.
Bilbo.
Bilbo.
Go back to 3 feet tall. Yeah.
3 feet tall. Bilbo.
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 You know, Trace.
Yes.
You got the point.
Yes.
Your team.
Of course.
Also, let this be a lesson to everyone in the audience. Don't give up.
Never give up on your dreams.
Never give up. And
believe in yourself.
Unlike Return of the King, that didn't even have an ending.
Yes. I'd just like to thank LOTR and STTNG.
Okay, so moving on.
Wow, there are absolutely no nerds here tonight.
I have never heard a quieter moment in my life.
I'm speaking your language.
For those of you who didn't know, that was Leonard Nimoy singing that.
Yes.
Oh, was it really? I didn't know
that.
Yeah.
Bilbo.
I never heard that song before, ever.
I didn't know it either.
It's, what else is on that album?
If I Had a Hammer is also on that. If I Had a Hammer,
I'd smash hammer this record.
Yeah.
I say that when I have road rage.
If I had a hammer, you'd be dead. Yeah.
I'm missing an envelope. How could I miss an
break out the wheel. Break out the wheel.
It was right in front of me. So we're going to bring out, we're going to do another home truth. So we're going to bring out another guest to do a truth or a lie. So please welcome to stage, Josie DeVore.
Yay. I'll get a dollar for that.
I'm excited. You excited?
I'm surprisingly aroused, yes.
I'm going to introduce this thing for Dana Schneider, who's not here. So here you go. Please. Open the envelope. Tell everyone it's inside.
He does occasionally yell.
Yeah.
And occasionally, I mean, whenever he opens his mouth.
I really seal these envelopes. I want this.
You did.
The anticipation I want to build right now.
You're a very good licker.
Thanks, Trace.
This is me pretending it's real or not.
Please read out.
Oh, I've got to read out?
You read out to the audience and to our contestants.
Shit, I thought I can get away with the fact that I don't know how to read this whole time. It says, during an awkward moment for a cast member at the Hall of Presidents, I had to introduce the show for them. Thankful, I write horribly. Thankfully, I memorized it.
I'm going to say false.
We'll go with that.
Which president were you playing?
Which president was I playing?
Yeah.
I wasn't playing the president. Trump. I just went like this a lot. It was great. The penguin thing he does.
What was your job at the Hall of Presidents?
It was the greeter.
Okay.
At the door.
Were you in like a costume or?
No, it's just like everybody wears it's.
Which part?
It's a lifestyle.
Which?
Okay.
It's a lifestyle there, and it's a magical uniform. It's a magical place.
Okay.
But it was just like a dress shirt with a little vest and pants that were blue.
But which park, Josie?
Which what? I'm sorry.
Which park?
Which park? That's a good question. What park is it at?
Who knows?
The Disney one.
I'm going to go with Islands of Adventure. I'm going to go with Islands of Adventure.
Islands of Adventure?
Yes.
The presidents of the Islands of Adventure.
The presidency is an adventure.
Mm-hmm. Who was it, though? The current president at this time?
It was Obama.
It was what? Who?
Obama. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. He was a president, right?
Wait, one of the presidents broke down? Is that what you're saying?
No, it was an awkward moment.
Okay.
And the host who introduces and stuff, she had something happen to her, and I had to take her place to introduce, basically just to start the show.
Oh, okay.
I just go and hit play, but like, hey, everyone, the president's going to be great. It's going to be so fun. And then you just hit play, and then they just talk.
What was the awkward moment? What happened to her? Did she get her period?
Did she take her head off? Because I hear you're not supposed to do that.
Funny story, # feminism, menses. Yes, she did get her period. She didn't know it was coming because she totally thought she was pregnant, but it's her own fault. Anyways, her period.
At any point did you fall through a plate glass window?
In upstate New York.
There was a vacuum, and a nurse did suck me with a vacuum. So I'm going to say no. These are facts. It's a Hoover. Was it a wet vac? I was a wet vac. Go on.
Mm-hmm. No, that was you answered it very well.
So wait, okay. So you had to do what during this awkward moment?
It was just like the introduction. Thank everybody for no flash photography, no filming, don't use lights, and then you just hit play.
And how did it go?
No, I'm not going to say that. If I say that, then you're going to know if it's true or not.
I mean, that's kind of the game. So
yeah. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for coming to Universal Studios Florida. no flash photography, no using film, please don't use. So basically, I was the president, is what I'm saying.
Oh, you got to actually be a president.
I got to be a president now.
What was your costume as president?
Okay, I lied about that. I wasn't the president at all. No, I just did the introduction. So I said, thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for coming out. Please don't use any flash photography or flash video. And this presentation will start shortly. I don't really know her lines too much. That's the problem.
So
I was just the greeter.
So it didn't require a costume on your part?
No. I just had the regular uniform, which is the vest, the blue pants.
And the awkwardness was that you didn't know the lines and stuff.
Well, the awkwardness was she had her period, and then I didn't know her lines. So I was just like, hey, because normally I'm just like, hey, thanks for coming. Enjoy. Hey.
How did you... So who was actually supposed to give the introduction? It was a human being, not an animatronic thing?
Yes.
And she suddenly, like, doubled over with severe cramps?
No, she came over as I'm greeting people to come inside.
Uh-huh.
And she's like, I've got to go.
OMG,
and
we're
supposed
my period.
Yeah, we're supposed to get a supervisor, but they don't have headsets because they're presenters. So it's literally just running there. So I'm like, okay. And I don't do well in front of crowds. So luckily, we don't have one. But it was very last minute, so I just knew no cameras.
Did you improvise in any way that was awkward? Like, did you say anything racist or disgusting? Or
no, Trump wasn't on there yet, so no, there was nothing to say.
I was going to ask: is at any point in the Hall of Presidents is the 25th Amendment evoked?
All the time.
Yeah. Only for cast members.
Yeah. Magical cast members, yeah.
How long did you work at Universal Studios?
For 2 weeks.
Two?
Were you fired as a result of this as a horrible, awkward incident?
Well, it was really 2 weeks and like 2 days. So the thing about Disney is you train for 2 weeks. Like, in the underground level. And you take a two-week training where you learn the history of Disney and all about Tinkerbell and that Mickey was originally, I think it's Oswald, the rabbit, and he was bought out, blah, blah, blah. And they convince you to sign to be a union, which most of those are already legal laws, so you really don't need to do it, but they force you to do it, and you take $5 out of your check. Anyways, and so I took training for 2 weeks.
I love watching Trace's face as he tries to put this together.
You were working for Disney, but at Universal Studios.
No, Universal Studios. It was Disney.
They had an understanding.
He was working for Universal Studios at Disney.
Yeah. I mean, get your facts straight.
Well, Disney owns everything.
I'm going to ask our two teams to confer. Josie, is there anything you would like to promote? You have some panels coming up this weekend.
I do have some panels. I have one tonight in 5 minutes. I'm in room 202, and it's a Japanese game show one, which is great, but unfortunately I don't speak Japanese, so I have no idea what the hell we're going to do.
I have an audience I can give you.
Thank you!
I'm on that with you.
You are?
Yeah.
We're running late.
Yes.
and I'm at booth 1014. I'm the guy with all the sexy Tina body pillows and too many pickle reeks that I can shove in my ass. Anyways, yeah, that's it. Yeah.
So, the problematics. Do you have a decision on this?
Yeah. We do.
Liar!
Okay.
Wait, liar!
That's a liar from the problematics?
Maybe I'm really good.
Shithouse Country?
Like Reese Witherspoon.
Truth or lie?
We're on board with it being a lie.
So we have two lies. Josie, is a lie or a truth?
Well, now I don't feel like saying anything.
Oh, don't be mad.
Well, I guess you're gonna
don't be mad.
The start time of your next
we have to
okay, this is what I will say. You guys are lucky I don't remember where the Hall of Presidents is. It's totally a lie.
Thank you, teams. And a big round of applause.
So believable.
For Josie, thank you for coming out.
Enjoy.
As we send him back to the Hall of Presidents of the Islands of Adventure.
I almost followed the Universal Studios.
The Islands of Adventure.
It was such a boring story.
You're wonderful. We love you.
At Euro Disney.
Disney Paris.
Disney Paris.
At least we've some incest
with
into
President
it.
Taft.
So let's understand what happened here. You wrote that as his unusual story.
I just want...
That is horrible.
In my defense, that was written 3 seconds before walking out on stage because everything about this is last minute.
Yeah, well, you sealed it pretty tight.
Yeah, I know, but you took all
you
the time
what?
Sealing the
you
envelope
know what? You know
instead
what?
Of thinking of a good
you
lie.
You would think you two would be thanking me for the easy points you just got.
Well.
But no.
If it involves Disney,
that is not that. How my friends operate during these quiz shows.
And when did they get here?
Ruthless, baby. Ruthless.
Wink Martindale does not bitch about his friends on...
Yeah, he does. He's,
yes, he does. He's
horrible. Well, backstage.
Wink Martindale's a horrible...
So what we're going to do is we're going to pick... this is our last game of the evening. We're running up
oh,
to
no.
the end. And we have to get songs in. Pick up songs for the two people who have not done it yet.
Oh.
So,
wait, is that me?
Oh, Diesel? That's you, boo.
I have to.
Yeah, get ready.
Bilbo.
Get ready.
Bilbo.
Bilbo.
These
Bilbo
song lyrics,
Bobagas.
By the way, available signed at our tables tomorrow for $20.
Nice.
Trace. Oh, wait, it's two pages.
Trace, again, these things cost money. These are going to be reused again and again. You will not be taking these with you. These are forever.
That was a lie.
Bill.
This is the lowest lying budget game show I've ever seen.
This is like this,
is
this makes
the lowest
the,
budget.
This makes the $1.95 beauty pageant look expensive.
Oh.
That was an actual show, folks.
$1.95?
$1.98, I think. Beauty pageant hosted by Rip Taylor. It was a Chuck Barris production.
The winner got a
but that's like the saddest.
I believe so,
like,
yeah.
A dollar, like it's named the dollar.
It was called the $1.98 beauty pageant, and it was hosted by Rip Taylor.
$2. Oh, yes.
I know the
yes,
chorus. I know the chorus.
Are you ready, Cecil?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. And I'm just going to start playing it. Let it be a happy surprise for the audience.
Okay, all right.
Baby, gonna hold her tight, gonna grab some afternoon delight. My motto's always been, when it's right, it's right. I wait until the middle of a cold, dark night.
Everything's a little clearer in the light of day, and we know that the night is always gonna be there anyway. Thinking of you's working up my appetite, looking forward to the little afternoon delight. Rubbing sticks and stones together makes the sparks ignite. And the thought of rubbing you is getting so exciting. Sky rockets in flight.
Sky afternoon. Afternoon delight.
I gotta give you that point.
That was like half a point.
Afternoon delight.
I mean, what is incredibly remarkable about that is it was the most beautifully atonal thing I think I've ever heard.
Listen,
it was Shatnerian interpretation.
That's right. It was a dramatic reading. Right.
You know, this is absolutely true. The Starland Vocal Band are still around, and the lead guy in it often calls the radio show that I'm on. The Sirius XM.
Who does?
Show. I forget the guy's name, but he's like the head guy from the Starland Vocal Band.
Wait,
he's a fan of our show, and he calls in like a couple every couple weeks.
Nice, what does he say?
Nice guy.
John Frank, ready for an afternoon delight of an opinion?
Yeah, afternoon delight guy.
Well, this is Lisa's first Gonzo quiz show, and she's going to be the one closing out our Gonzo quiz show. Oh, and this is our big finale. This is the big number. Are you ready? So
yes, I'm ready. Okay, should I say what it is?
I think we'll go right into it.
Let's go into it.
People are going to know this one.
I paid my dues.
Oh, my God.
Time after time.
A nice, easy one.
I've done my sentence, but committed no crime. And bad mistakes.
I've made a few.
Champions, my friends, and we'll keep on fighting to the end. We are the champions. We are the champions. Sorry, but no time for losers, because we are the champions.
That was very close.
Spot on.
Okay. Bravo.
That's a point.
It's exact.
Perfect.
Wow. Well, thank you everyone for coming out. I want to thank Symphony Sanders, Cecil Baldwin, Corbett.
Wait, who won?
No, hold on. I'm going to get to that.
Wait a second.
There are winners.
He'll get to that. I think the audience is already feeling that nobody won in this room.
I'm making this interesting for them, and now for me, and you pointing out the thing I just forgot. So Frank Conniff, Lisa Correo, Trace Beaulieu, and we're going to get totals right now. So the Problematics, their total is? 20. And now, Shithouse Country.
So close, 21.
Oh!
Oh! Wow. We are the champions.
Truly a battle of greats.
I mean, I guess the lesson... Really.
Can I keep this mask?
Really, to be learned from that, is that cheaters never prosper, even when I was the one cheating for your team.
Yeah. No, every time at the end of this, I tell myself, Frank, don't get so emotionally invested in this.
I want you all to give a big round of applause for our winners, the Problematics.
Nice. Thank you, darling.
Number one.
Bill.
Whoa.
One. Oh, great.
Again, the budget extended to the prizes.
This is where I start to feel like a winner.
As the team captain.
Oh, yes.
The ritual humiliation is part of the championship.
I hope you all...
Well, I take it back. This is not the lowest budget game show ever.
I just want to say that for our...
Ka-ching!
I'm not going to say losing team, but the team who lost. Shithouse Country, you each get a ball. I want you to give these back after the show, backstage. Don't make it awkward on stage.
You're running low on balls, buddy.
All
I also want to thank our special Truth or Lie guests, Michael Kingston and Josie DeVore. Big round of applause for them.
Yeah. Great stories. Great stories.
Now, we have a lot of panels coming up this weekend. We have a Mystery Science Theater You Know More Than We Do panel that'll have Trace, Frank, and Bill. We have a Welcome to Night Vale panel with Cecil and Symphony.
Yes.
We have a Real Crime panel, which is really fun, that Trace, Frank, and Bill and I do, that is on Sunday, that I hope you turn out for. It is really great. Lisa, what do you have coming up this weekend? You have something that you're due to go run to in a second.
I don't know. Listen, guys, come visit me at my booth. Also, I have a new Patreon, so if any of you want to give me money, you can do that and get exclusive content. I'm doing shows all weekend. I've got Couch Potatoes. I've got stand-up tomorrow. So come check out at least maybe the stand-up show. It would be great with Mike Kaplan tomorrow. Yeah.
That's a great show, her and Mike Kaplan together doing stand-up. That is a great stand-up show.
And I am Ken Plume. I thank you for coming out. I also have a Patreon, patreon.com/KenPlume. And guess what? I even have Ken PD Snidecast CDs for anyone who wants to buy those that are pre-signed by Dana Snyder and myself.
Nice.
So even though Dana's not here, little piece of Dana. And the show's okay, I guess. Thank you very much for coming out.
Thank you.
Thank you.
A round of applause for our team.
Thank you. Tell your friend.
Hey, guys, we hope you liked that video, and we hope to see you at the next Florida Supercon, which, by the way, is July 12th through the 15th at the Greater Fort Lauderdale Convention Center. You can get tickets by clicking right here. It's that easy. Click here to see some more great videos, and click here to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you next time.